Through a sequence of videos and exercises, we've now arrived at this picture and an implementation that orders the loops as PI. Let's see, the PI is a loop over column blocks and row blocks of A, followed by a JI loop that hits all of the micro tiles in the block of C. Actually, that's all of these micro tiles. And then a call to a microkernel that places a micro tile of C into the registers and then calls the microkernel with micro panels of A and B. Let's try to go back and revisit all of this so that it becomes really clear what happens. And along the way, remember that we empirically determined that the block of A should be in the L2 cache. All right, so let's have a look at that. Here we have a matrix-matrix multiply. C is updated by multiplying A times B. The loop index by P means that we are partitioning A into column panels and B into row panels. And then inside of that loop, what we do is this times that plus this times that plus this times that. So let's focus on one of these. This is what happens in one iteration of the loop indexed by P. We then have a loop indexed by I. I means that we're partitioning C and A. So now what we do is say, okay, let's take C and partition it into row panels, and let's take our column panel of A and partition it into blocks. What we now need to do is a block of A times the row panel of B to update the row panel of C. And then we move on to the next row panel of C, which is the next block of A times the same row panel of B, and so forth. All right, so let's home in on one of those. Let's make it the same one. How do we implement that matrix-matrix multiply? Well, that puts us right here in this picture right here. And what we empirically determined was that this block of A should be sized so that it can reside in the L2 cache. So let's picture that. Let's take this block of A and let's picture it now residing in the L2 cache. Next, we're going to loop over all of the micro tiles of C. And we're going to do that by first looping over the J index, that means in this direction. And then once we fix the J index, we're going to march down that column. All right, so what does that mean? What that means is that our block of C is partitioned into these, let's call them micro panels as well. And our block of B is partitioned into micro panels. And what we now need to do is the block of A times the micro panel of B to update a micro panel of C, and we loop through that. That is our loop indexed with J. Good. What do we do next? Well, notice that we're going to multiply a typical micro panel of B by the block of A to update a micro panel of C. But the way we do that is by partitioning that micro panel of C, which would reside right here, into micro tiles. So now we're going to loop over I. And what that does for a typical micro tile of C is partition that into small blocks, each of which fits in registers. And similarly, it partitions the block of A into microtiles as well. And let's reflect that up here as well. Now, what we reasoned was that the microtile of C really needs to be placed in the registers. So a typical microtile of C now ends up in the registers right there. And then what you end up doing is multiplying the corresponding microtile of A times the microtile of B. Now, registers are inherently about placing data there that gets reused many times. That's why we placed the microtile of C in registers here, because it got reused over many rank one updates as we implemented our microkernel. It's why we placed our block of A here, because that block of A is being reused for many microtiles of B, updating the corresponding microtiles of C. The question now becomes, where should we really place this microtile of B that we're now using? And notice that it gets reused many times, so it should be somewhere in some cache, but notice that it is relatively small. So maybe instead of placing it in the L2 cache, what we should do is place it in the L1 cache. Okay? It gets used many times. By placing it in the L1 cache, it becomes cheaper to bring that data into the registers. It is more expensive to use the data from A, but notice that the data from A gets reused over many computations with data from B. And everything starts falling in place. Right, so this is really kind of the picture to keep in mind. And you know, I reiterate that we can explicitly control what goes into registers, but it really is the ordering of the loops and the reuse of the data that keeps data in the L1, L2 cache. Right, so now we have seen how we might usefully use two levels of the cache. But a modern architecture has three levels of cache these days. So for that, we're going to talk about what to do next in the next unit.